Nama saya Haji Awang bin Cekik. Saya berasal dari Pulau Sudong dan saya beranak tahun 15 hari bulan 3 1952 dan terus tinggal di Sudong sampai tahun 1979 Pulau Sudong pindah Singapura. Dan pindah Singapura sampai sekarang lah.
Hello, I'm Zakir Hussein Khokon. I moved from Bangladesh 2003 to Singapore. Now I work in construction industry as a project coordinator, quality controller. Beside of my work, we try to make a good bonding with local and migrant using literature and arts.
Hi, my name is Kim and I'm an urban farmer. Besides growing food, I actually also design and build edible gardens. So for simplicity's sake, usually I just tell people I'm a farmer, but I'm a foodscaper. So meaning, instead of designing and building gardens with ornamental plants, like landscaping, we do it with food, so foodscaping. When I saw this, I actually thought that the sculpture was purposely done in a haphazard, messy way to remind us and to make us realize that we're actually creating a lot of waste with construction, and that, you know, all these construction debris left behind from building all these tall buildings are actually still lying around. They're not disposed of. I think if I'm an artist who is tasked to do something with this structure, I would maybe take the entire structure and just put it in the soil and then let plants grow over it. Maybe hang plants here and there, greenify the area, let climbers climb up. Yeah, it's actually quite a good trellis for climbing plants.
Pada saya, kalau benda begini kita buat daripada buluh ataupun rotan, bagus juga. Cuma tak banyak sangat lah. Ini pakai bahan-bahan macam welding apa kan. Itu pakai tali sikit lebih kurang dah boleh lah kalau buluh dengan rotan tadi kan.
I will take this and rebuild or redo this design, and that redesign will be home or house. I will make a house with this all the material. As a migrant worker, I am very far from my house.
Saya tengok pun bagus jugalah. Kalau benda-benda yang terbuang ni diambil dan dijadikan macam bentuk kapal ini pun bagus pada saya lah. Tapi kalau saya ingat mana Singapura dalam tahun 60-an ke atas ini, saya teringat pulau saya. Masa itu kayu-kayu hanyut, orang-orang pulau saya ambil kayu-kayu itu bikin-bikin piasan, bentuk-bentuk macam-macam bentuk lah. Dan termasuk siput-siput apa semua diambil. Masa datang kadang setiap hari Sabtu, hari Minggu, banyak pelancong datang. Dia orang pun datang beli, dia tengok piasan-piasan itu cantik pada dia orang. Jadi sampai dia orang beli semua barang-barang ini, dia orang sukalah. Jadi orang kampung, orang pulau saya dulu memang hobi. Setiap Sabtu Minggu memang itulah, kalau ada benda-benda yang aneh sikit kan. Itu diambil, dibuat sesuatu dan nanti Sabtu hari Minggu dijual kan gitu.
This sculpture actually also reminds me a lot of the metal rods that I sometimes find in the gardens that I have to build and install at. So usually when we go down to install or build the gardens, right, we'll find these buried underground because it's like excess, you know, unused and unwanted. Yeah, but it's actually quite dangerous. Because for people who don't know, when they dig the soil or when they step on it, they can actually get hurt.
So first impression that I am in front of a ship. And another thing is very wonderful, the welding, the quality of the welding is wonderful. And how this world with each other, the shape and the arrangement. As a migrant worker, I find this is very important for us also, because this is related to the welding and arrangement. And in construction and shipyard, migrant workers do the welding works. And they are very good in welding, skill in welding. So when I see the welding area, I remind them that how they weld every day. And this welding work is not very easy work. This is very tough work. Sometimes it's risky also, but they're doing very good work in Singapore. And for change the landscape in Singapore, this welding is a very important part. And welding not only in shipyard, in construction. Without construction, cannot construct. When I see this, then one poem come in my mind. The poem title is Welding Sparks. Just I share with you one line or two lines, few lines. Yeah. When the light of welding sparks touches our eyes, the color of ice changes. The color of our eyes turns red, and it hurts a lot, can't sleep. But we are welding sorrow with happiness. We are welding memories with dreams. Our eyes glowing in the light of the welding sparks. Our tired faces hide in the light of the welding sparks. So I find any throw item, if can organize or arrange nicely, that can make a different meaning, and a different meaning for the life and views. Yeah, how I find these things very interesting. And in this is very, very, very meaningful.
So, when I look at the natural landscape, actually, I don't think some of these plants can be found in Singapore's natural environment. There's a lot of coconuts in the middle of a jungle, whereas coconuts are usually found by the beach.
When I saw this photo, my first time, my mind catch the tiger action. How the action? And surrounding look like tiger jump from jungle, and people are very scared. Color of the workers is saying that they are come from South Asia, like India, Bangladesh, or Sri Lanka. Yeah, and the British guy is saying, British guy already very obvious in photo. But how Kim say the plants about your experience? Do the plants not like the natural jungle? So jungle plants is very different. Jungle plant is not very organized, but here look like very organized. But jungle plant cannot be organized very, very nicely, right? Yeah.
Saya dekat Pulau Sudong tak ada ini semua. Ini semua tak ada. Cuma kita nelayan aja, kerja laut. Di minyak Sudong memang tak ada lah benda-benda gini. Lagipun keadaan kita dekat Sudong aman, tenteram. Tak ada gaduh-gaduh, tak ada apa semua kan. Tanah upahit dan semua tak ada semua. Nah, jadi, kalau saya tengok kalau dekat gambar ni, ini kita cerita balik pada saya lah. Ini semua Jerman punya drawing ni, idea lah. Sepada idea on dia lah. Pasal, kalau Singapore pun dulu, tak ada ni semua. Kalau Singapore, tak ada. Singapore pasal kita tengok orang, masa tengah bikin jalan dengan ini British tengah sebel kan, dari tiba-tiba tengah kerja harimau datang serang, jadi dia macam kelang kabut lah, jatuh-jatuh itu semua kan. Itulah, ini pasal gambar ni, kalau dekat Pulau Sudong tu memang tidak ada apa-apa. Tidak ada binatang apa-apa kalau dekat Sudong.
Yeah, I actually find it interesting how Awang also said that this never happened when he was living as a villager in a fishing village. And from the stories that I heard when I was younger, is that tiger attacks did happen, but it only happened around the mid-1900s or towards a little bit later, if I'm not wrong. And those usually happened because, I think it's because we were encroaching on the natural habitats, right?
Yeah, present when I see this print, this saying that how was really Singapore? They have jungle and tiger and other things. But if you look present day, a lot of change. You could not find this kind of environment in Singapore. The kids cannot imagine this have in Singapore in the present day. This is very interesting.
Pada saya dululah, dulu saya biasa jugalah pergi Chua Chu Kang, Lim Chu Kang, West Coast, Bonley. Saya biasa jugalah, tapi tengok dia orang tanam sayur ni semua suka-suka juga, sukalah. Saya paling sukalah tengok. Kadang-kadang dia kasih kita ambil bawa balik dulu.
This painting actually remind about my childhood, that this kind of environment I seen from my childhood, and present day I could not find this kind of field, and in future generation I think they will never see this kind of this kind of green field in their land.
In this painting I can see that a kampong area, but then at the background in a distance away I see a lot of like HDBs, there's a lot of construction going on, bulldozers, so it almost feels as if the adults telling the kid that, you know, oh, soon this plot of land is going to go and we're not going to be able to grow vegetables anymore, because I think this is around the era of 1960s or 1970s, when a lot of the kampong areas were being cleared out, and people were being rehomed into HDBs or relocated elsewhere because they wanted to clear all the kampong and clean it, so-called clean it up for urban development.
Kalau kerajaan dia nak ambil pun kita terpaksa ikut jugalah. Padahal kalau kita nak bertahan pun tak guna. Nanti dipaksa-paksa dalam pemerintah, macam ibarat saya juga dulu. Nah, ini dulu dia orang dulu yang pindah ni, kena pindah. Nah, dia orang kena pindah, yang ada tak tahulah pindah kat mana dia orang kena kan. Kesian jugalah tengok kan, padahal kebun-kebun sayur dia orang ni dulu, tanam punya baik, subur, segar, sayur-sayur ni kita kalau nak minum, tak pergi pasar pun kita pergi dekat kebun ini pun kita boleh dapat makan yang fresh punya lah. Nah, bahan-bahan fresh sini. Tapi sekarang dah tak ada, ada-ada tapi jauh lah, kita nak cari pun susah. Macam dekat gambar-gambar ini semua kan, kita tengok macam orang tua ni hampa jugalah harapan dia. Dia cakap dengan budak pasal nak kena pindah. Jadi saya nak cakap banyak pun susah juga lah. Kesian lah tengok pada hari ini.
I find out the present day some things is happening now. People are trying to connect with the land, like they try to do gardening in front of their house, though they living in HDB, but they try to connect with do some gardening. And if they have holiday, they try to go the farm, to visit the farm.
I think it's a bit ironic that we are in this situation here today talking about that, because currently the government's also trying to push people towards growing their own food, you know, growing our vegetables locally, like, you know, the local food movement. Yeah, and then if you just like compare it to a few decades ago, the government was trying to encourage people to move off the land and move into high-rise buildings.
Sekarang orang Singapura pula, government pula suruh kita try cocok ini tanam sendiri dekat rumah ke dekat mana, luar tanam. Jadi masalah dia susah sikit lah pada saya. Tak macam dulu-dulu lah. Dulu kalau tanam, wah besar, mewah. Kita pun boleh tolong. Ha, angkat air, siram air dulu kan. Siram air tolong. Sekarang atas blok, bikin tanam sayur. Kita untuk menampungkan keadaan zaman sekarang lah. Masa kita Singapura sekarang mungkin kekurangan. Jadi Singapura sekarang nak galakkan rakyat-rakyat dia tanam sayur dekat daerah-daerah blok lah. Atas blok ke daerah mana-mana dia ada sediakan tanah untuk kita orang Singapura. Sekarang pada saya itu masalah. Mana yang ada duit lah, yang orang ada duit bolehlah bikin itu kan. Kalau kita tak ada duit, beli pasar aje lah. Itu aje lah pada saya.
I think that's a very good point, because it's definitely very difficult to find large pieces of land like this in Singapore now. But the thing is, going forward, it's very important to teach the younger generation to know where their food comes from, how food is grown, so that from there they can actually learn how to treasure and value food and the effort that's been put into producing all that.
Yeah, how Kim says, I agree with you. And still there have hope that future generation will be connected with land and they will find their space themselves. Yeah, I think this is very important for the future, and there have hope, and there have the different type of design will become for survive and growing up. Yeah. So this painting is really very interesting, that the dimension, how is the changing the land, how is the changing, and this changing not only in Singapore, I think everywhere this kind of change happening. So it's still today also happening. From the artwork Interrupted Road Survey in Singapore, that actually I learned that a lot of change happened in Singapore compared to that artwork and the present day. And the sculpture, that artwork also without migrant workers, that welding work, actually Singapore cannot be a Singapore today. And cannot grow vegetable anymore. That actually very moving, one kind of moving painting for learn about Singapore, that how was the land, how was the Singapore in 1968, and after a long the way today in 2021, is how is the a lot of change happened in Singapore.
All three artworks remind me of the kind of conversations that I have to have and engage in frequently with people every day. And it also reminds me a lot about this constant tension that we face in Singapore between humans and nature. So we're always striving for urban development and trying to, you know, improve our urban infrastructure, but then at the same time, doing so would sometimes sacrifice the what little left of our natural space that we have in Singapore. So I hope that people will think more about how going into the future, we should also be mindful and be conscious of what happened in the past. And I think as landscapes change, it's also more of the mindset and the cultural values that change that's more important. Yeah, so when we move forward, I think it's also good to think about what kind of cultural values and mindsets we want to preserve and remember. I probably remember for a long time how each of us approached each artwork very differently, and how we see things are actually very much colored by our past experiences and our upbringing and our background. Yeah, so there's actually many different ways to look at a particular artwork, and I enjoyed that.
Pada saya, semualah apa yang saya tengok, apa yang saya cakap, yang buat penerangan tadi, semua senanglah pada saya dalam ingatan saya lah itu. Dalam percakapan dengan ramai-ramai tadi tiga orang tadi, saya sukalah. Saya akan ingat selama-lamalah. Dengan lagipun saya pertama dalam galeri, jadi saya besar hatilah. Yang satu dan tiga tu yang sayur tu tadi tu. Yang kebun lah. Yang kebun sayur tadi tu. Itulah yang buat penarikkan lah. Banyak-banyak sikit pembincangan tadi kan. Kesian tengok dia orang kan kerja. Kerajaan dah ambil tempat ini dia orang. Jadi kita sebagai kawan, sebagai ini simpati lah. Saya pun memang kesian lah tengok dia orang. Orang tua-tua dia, bapak dia, mak dia. Itulah saya memang tak boleh cakap lah. Kadang kesian tengok dia orang nangis apa-apa nak buat kan. Saya pun tak boleh cakap lah, tak boleh tolong pasal itu semua kerajaan punya kendak. Tapi alhamdulillah lah, walaupun macam mana pun iyalah kata orang ada jugalah, masih bertahan jugalah lagi yang ada lim cukang pun masih ada lagi. Tapi dah semua dah tak macam dulu lagi lah. Nah, sekarang pun dah banyak berubah lah. Pada pengam baru saya ini pasal gambar-gambar tadi kita agak lama sikit, itu yang buat bagus pada saya lah untuk berbincang tadi kan. Tiga-tiga gambar tu kita berbincang lama lah. Kira lama sikit lah, tak macam yang sudah. Itu rasa puas lah rasa saya tadi. Hati saya senang lah kalau ni. Itu buat kenang-kenangan lah. Saya pun rasa bangga dapat kerjasama dengan pihak Grelly. Dapat menjayakan tugas-tugas ini dengan besar hati lah.